Good morning, good afternoon to all. Welcome to the United Arab Emirates, the country of Zayed, the country of giving, the country of development and sustainability.
Excellencies, dear friends, colleagues, members of every delegation, it is an honor to be with you today. And I am so glad that this day has finally arrived. And as my first official act as COP president, allow me to express my gratitude to my very dear friend, Samih Shukri, Your Excellency. You have led this conference with vision, purpose, and integrity. We are indebted to you for your service, your accomplishments, and your commitment to climate progress. And allow me to also extend my gratitude to every person in this room. We come from different nations, different backgrounds, and different generations. Yet, we share something vital. At some point in each of our lives, we all made a choice. A choice to help carry the burden of a great responsibility, to raise our hands and bear some portion of the weight on our shoulder. That choice is why we are all here in the United Arab Emirates today. The UAE is deeply proud and humbled to be hosting COP28 at a pivotal time in this critical decade for climate action. We know, as you know, the gravity of this moment. We feel, as you feel, the urgency of this work. And we see, as you see, that the world has reached a crossroads. And yes, since Paris, we have made some progress. But we also know that the road we have been on will not get us to our destination in time. The science has spoken. It has been loud and clear. It has confirmed that the moment is now to find a new road, a road wide enough for all of us, free of the obstacles and the detours of the past. That new road starts with a decision on the global stocktake, a decision that is ambitious, corrects course, and accelerates action to 2030. Through the global stocktake, we have a chance to unite the three core elements of the climate agenda. We can finally bring mitigation, adaptation, and means of implementation, which includes finance, under one umbrella, united around higher ambition, giving clear direction on nationally determined contributions, and connecting everything we agree here to practical action in the real world. Every nation, every sector, and every one of us has an urgent and an immediate role to play. For my part, I pledge that I will run an inclusive and transparent process, one that encourages free and open discussion between all parties. I ask you to start this COP with a different mindset. I ask you to adopt a different way of thinking, and I ask you to be flexible. We must ensure that this COP delivers the most ambitious global stocktake possible. So let's work efficiently. Let's agree on the agenda and move to text quickly. Please. We have no time to waste. Friends, I believe that the United Arab Emirates reflects the spirit we need at this COP. My country is only 2 years older than me, and that makes it a young country, in fact, a very young country. It is a nation that rose up from the desert through the vision and foresight of our late founding father, Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan, and the conviction and aspiration he passed on to the generations that followed. And now, 52 years later, just look around. We may be a young nation, but we have big ambitions and hold fast to principles like collaboration, optimism, true partnership, determination, and commitment. These are the ingredients that make up the DNA of the United Arab Emirates. And it's these core values of trust, purpose, partnership, and pragmatism that I believe must define the DNA of COP28. That means it is essential that no issue is left off the table. And yes, as I have been saying, we must look for ways and ensure the inclusion of the role of fossil fuels. I know there are strong views about the idea of including language on fossil fuels and renewables in the negotiated text. We collectively have the power to do something unprecedented. In fact, we have no choice but to go the very unconventional way. I ask you all to work together. Be flexible. Find common ground. Come forward with solutions and achieve consensus. And never lose sight of our North Star of 1.5. Because that is what I am going to stay laser focused on. Excellencies, dear friends, we all know that a key success factor across climate agenda is finance. And for too long, finance has not been available, accessible, or affordable. This presidency is committed to unlocking finance to ensure that the Global South does not have to choose between development and climate action. Let this be the year that climate finance meets the magnitude of the moment. Let this be the COP where we deliver on our promises from the 100 billion to loss and damage. And on loss and damage, I know how important this issue is to the parties, particularly to the most vulnerable. What began in Sharm el-Sheikh and what was given critical momentum and traction in Abu Dhabi earlier this month must now be delivered and actioned here in Dubai. And allow me here to pause for a moment to honor the memory of our distinguished colleague and my dear friend, Salim al-Haq. He devoted his entire career to the cause of finding a way to address loss and damage. And I personally benefited from his advice and his experience, particularly on the imperative to shift the world's focus to the needs of adaptation. Excellencies, adaptation must be at the heart of our action. We must bridge the finance gap and agree on a robust framework for the global goal. Let's put nature, lives, and livelihoods at the core of our national plans. Let's finally face the issues that are critical to adaptation, like water, food, agriculture, and health. And that is why I am proud that this COP will be the first to host a climate health ministerial. Colleagues, I want this COP to be the COP that maximizes momentum on mitigation. Today, countries representing more than 85% of the world's economy are behind COP28's goal of tripling renewable energy capacity by 2030. And we are reaching critical mass on the goal to double energy efficiency by 2030. This is how we will transition away from unabated coal. Let me also encourage countries to establish net zero methane emission targets as part of their next round of NDCs. Zeroing out methane emissions can make a huge impact in the shortest time frame. Colleagues, and let history reflect the fact that this is the presidency that made a bold choice to proactively engage with oil and gas companies. We had many hard discussions. Let me tell you, that wasn't easy. But today, many of these companies are committing to zero methane emissions by 2030 for the first time. And now, many national oil companies have adopted net zero 2050 targets for the first time. And I'm grateful that they have stepped up to join this game-changing journey. But I must say, it is not enough. And I know that they can do much more. They can lead the way. And them leading the way will ensure that others follow and catch up. At the same time, as part of this presidency's action agenda, we are engaging with other high-emitting sectors like heavy transportation, aluminum, steel, and cement, all in an effort to accelerate decarbonization at scale. I'm calling on all industries to engage, to innovate, to modernize, and invest in clean technologies. Colleagues, my friends, my partners, the next 2 weeks will not be easy. Let's remember, our task is not only about negotiating text or putting words on paper. It is about improving lives. It is about people. From the students I met in Bangladesh to the young entrepreneurs I saw in Nairobi, to indigenous communities I visited in the Amazon basin. All of us want and need the same things: clean air, clean water, healthy food, economies, and opportunities for ourselves and our families. And of course, we want a safe and a secure future. Is that too much to ask? Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, my friends and my partners, we all made a choice to be here at this time. We understand the gravity of the situation, and I know that we all respect the science. Today, we need to follow through. Take that new road, and let's bring everyone on board with us. If we want to accelerate progress across the climate agenda, we must apply a positive can-do vision to get a GST decision with the highest ambition. We must translate the negotiated outcomes into real results in the real world. And we must use the next 2 weeks wisely. Take a no-nonsense approach with no delays. Let's restore faith in multilateralism. Let's bring back the lost trust in multilateralism. And let's deliver some good news to the world that really needs it today. And friends, I'll be right there, at your side, every step of the way. I will roll up my own sleeves alongside you. Let's rise above our differences to make the difference for future generations. Right now, here in the United Arab Emirates, I'm calling you all to unite, to act, and to deliver. I thank you.